This recording shows a proof of the gradient dot rho times the velocity vector in cylindrical coordinates. In this problem, you're given the definition of the gradient in cylindrical coordinates and two hints. The first, that the differential of the unit vector in the radial direction with respect to theta is equal to the unit vector in the theta direction. And the second is the derivative of the unit vector in the theta direction with respect to theta is equal to the negative of the unit vector in the radial direction. Also, you're given the final answer. So you're given the gradient dot rho times the velocity vector, and you're just asked to prove this. So show that you can derive this equation. So the first thing we should do is substitute what we know for the gradient dot rho times the velocity vector. So we know the gradient, and that's just equal to what's given above, and that's dot rho times the velocity vector. And the velocity vector is just the velocity in each direction times the unit vector in that direction. So unit vector in the radial direction times velocity in the radial direction plus unit vector in the theta direction times velocity in the theta direction plus unit vector in the z direction times velocity in the z direction. So let's go through and FOIL this equation. So the first term times all of this. So this is er hat dot del r rho. And for the second term, e theta hat dot 1 over r del theta rho times the same velocity vector. And for the third term, k hat dot del z rho, again, times the velocity vector. So now let's go through and evaluate the partial differentials. So for the first one, let's evaluate the partial with respect to r. So this will be er hat dot rho times second term times derivative of the first, so der hat dr plus er hat dot rho times first term times the derivative of the second. So er hat d dr of vr. If we look, e theta hat v theta, the rest of these terms are not a function of r, so their derivatives will be equal to 0. So now let's go to the next line and evaluate the derivatives with respect to theta. So this first term will be e theta hat dot rho 1 over r, second term, so vr, times the derivative of the first, so er der hat e theta plus e theta hat dot rho 1 over r, first term, so er hat times the derivative of the second, so d theta of vr. For this next term, e theta hat dot rho 1 over r, second term, v theta, derivative of the first, d e theta hat d theta plus e theta dot rho 1 over r, first term, e theta hat, derivative d d theta of the second term, so v theta. Let's scroll down. I'll just continue on the next page. And now we'll go and evaluate the derivatives with respect to k. Similar to above, k and vz are not functions of theta, so their derivatives will be 0. Similarly down here, vr, v theta aren't functions of z, so their derivatives will be 0, and we'll just be left with the two partials from here. So this will be k hat dot rho second term vz derivative of the first d k hat dz plus k hat dot rho second term k hat derivative of the first dvz dz. So now let's go through and evaluate these dot products. Here, er hat dot rho vr, this dot product is equal to 0. If we go through to the next term, er hat dot er hat is equal to 1, so we'll be left with d dr of rho vr. Next, if we make our substitution, if we look at our hint, we're told that this derivative here is equal to e theta hat. So when we evaluate this dot product, e theta hat dot e theta hat will be 1, and we'll just be left with rho vr over r. If we look at the next term, we'll see that e theta hat dot er hat will be equal to 0. So this term will go to 0. If we look at the next part, we're told that this derivative here is equal to minus er hat, minus just er hat, just from the second hint up here. So when we evaluate this dot product, e theta hat dot er hat, that'll be equal to 0. So this term goes to 0. If we evaluate this term, e theta hat dot e theta hat is equal to 1. So we'll have 1 over r d d theta rho v theta. If we look at the next line, just the plus sign, on the next line, k hat dot rho vz, this term, this goes to 0. If we evaluate this dot product, k hat dot k hat is equal to 1, and we'll be left with d dz of rho vz. So now let's go and see how close we are to the equation that we're given for the gradient dot rho times the velocity vector. So dz rho vz is in the equation up here. So that's good. 1 over r d d theta rho times v theta is in the equation up here. So this is good. And then we have two terms here and one term left up here. So we want to ask ourselves, are these two terms equal to the one term above? So let's go and write that. So let's say, is d dr rho vr plus rho vr over r equal to, so this is just asking, is this, are these two things equal? 1 over r d dr r rho vr. So that's just the final term that's left in this equation given to us above. So let's just factor out this rho. So this is equal to rho over r times the derivative of d dr of r vr. So if we just evaluate this partial derivative, we'll say that rho over r times vr d r dr plus r times d vr dr. So if we just derivative of r with respect to r, this term is 1. So this leaves us with, if we just factor this back in, this will be, this term goes to rho vr over r plus, foiling this one, the r's will cancel, and we'll be left with del r of rho vr, factoring this rho back in. And then we'll see that this term here is equal to this. So we have shown this proof to be true that this gradient rho, this gradient dot rho times the velocity vector is equal to this equation that's given here.